Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about NumPy arrays methods and the axis, how it will works. Those method works on axis. This point is very, very important to understand. In our previous classes, we already discussed about the basics of arrays and how memory is allocated to arrays. This is a continuation class. Please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete Python language. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, let's take some examples and understand how NumPy arrays methods works on the axis. This point is very, very important. Most of them will confuse how they are working on the axis. Okay, we'll get clarity here. Let's take this example. We are taking a two-dimensional array, hoping that you already know what's two-dimensional array, what's the indexes are, all the basics are discussed previously. Based on that, we will continue this class. X is equal to, this is a two-dimensional array. These are the elements 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 9, 8, 1, 7. So how we define the two-dimensional array? We are using a function called array function, and it will define a n-dimensional array object. Means n-dimensional array class object will be returned, that is saved in a variable called x. Now we can use this x as an n-dimensional array object, meaning we can use all the attributes and methods that are present on this n-dimensional array class. So now we are going to discuss what's some of the methods, not all the methods, whatever required for this playlist. We will discuss some of the methods and attributes, some of the methods required in our data science course. There we will discuss what's the methods that are required in our data science course, data science playlist. There we will discuss the remaining methods. Okay, coming to this, let's assume that this is the two-dimensional array which we defined to the variable x. Now we can use the methods that are present in the n-dimensional array class. So one of the method is x.argmaxOf. So what's the meaning, what this method will do here? Argmax method will identify the maximum element index value. That is what it is going to identify. It will return the index values. Where the maximum element is, the maximum element index will be returned. And here it is mentioned as axis is equal to 0. So we default, we think that axis is equal to 0 means it will apply on the row side. Axis is equal to 1 means it will apply in the column side. But there is a small difference for this. Let's try to understand that axis is equal to 0 means it will apply in this direction. In this direction means it is not applying on the row side. It is applying on the column side. So 4, 3, 8. Out of this, which one is the maximum? 8 is the maximum. What's the index? 2 is the index. That index value will be identified. 5, 4, 1. What's the maximum value? 5 is the maximum value. So what's the index? 0 is the index. 6, 9, 7. What is the maximum value? 9 is the maximum value. What's the index? 1 is the index value. This is how axis is equal to 0 means it will apply this side. This point we have to understand. Okay, so what's the axis value? 201. Axis is equal to 0 means what's the maximum values indexes? First one 2, second one 0, third one is 1. So axis is equal to 1 means it will apply in this direction. In this direction means it will apply on the row side 4, 5, 6. What's the maximum value? 6 is the maximum. What's the index? 2 is the index. 3, 4, 9. What's the maximum value? 9 is the maximum. What's the index? 2 is the index. 8, 1, 7. What's the maximum value? 8. What's the index value for that? 0 is the index. So that is how. So here we have written a mistake. 2, 2, 2. It's the 8 is the maximum. So 0 is the index. So that is how it will work on argmax axis is equal to 0 and axis is equal to 1. So what happens if you don't give any axis value? X is equal to x dot argmax of axis is not defined. What happens here is it will take the elements in the sequential order 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 9, 8, 1, 7. Take it in the sequence. Out of all those elements, what's the maximum value is? Maximum value is at 9. 0 index 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th index. It will take all the elements in the sequence and wherever it finds the maximum value, that index value will be given as the output. So what's the index we got here? 5 is the index we got here. So 5 is the output. Let's try to understand how it happens in the three-dimensional arrays. So this is our three-dimensional array, and this is one two-dimensional, this is other two-dimensional array. If these are placed like this, first one, this is the first one, after that if you place the second one, this is how three-dimensional arrays are. So this first one is given as index, three-dimension index. Third dimension index is a 0th index, this is first index. So based on this, if axis is equal to 0, it will work like this. 4 and 8, which one is the maximum one? 8 is the maximum. What's the index for this? Third dimension index, 8 is the index is 1. So 1 will be provided. 5 and 11, what's the maximum value? 11 is the maximum. What's the index? 1 is the index. 6 and 7, 7 is the maximum. What's the index? 1. 3 and 9, what's the maximum value? 9 is the maximum. What's the index? 1 is the index. 4 and 1, 4 is the maximum. What's the index? 0 is the index. 9 and 2, 0 is the index. 8 and 6, what's the maximum value? If you place it like this, it will work like this. The elements. That is how axis is equal to 0 works in three-dimensional arrays. So output is 111, 100, 010. If axis is equal to 1, how it works? It works like this. It will work like this. This is how it will work. Means, see here. 4, 3, 8. What is the maximum value? 8 is the maximum value. So what's the index? 0, 1, 2. 2 is the index. 5, 4, 1. What is the maximum? 5 is the maximum. What's the index? 0. Here, this is third dimension index. We are having remaining indexes also. We did not mention the remaining index. These are 0, 1, 2. These are 0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2. We are under an assumption that you already know those indexes. So 6, 9, 7. What's the maximum one? 9 is the maximum one. What's the index? 1 is the index here. 1 is the index here. So 2, 0, 1 is the index. Like that, it will apply on the second also. 8, 9, 6. What's the maximum? 9 is the maximum. 1 is the index. 11, 1, 12. 12 is the maximum. 2 is the index. 7, 2, 4. 7 is the maximum. 0 is the index. So the output is 1, 2, 0. The same way, axis is equal to 2 means it will apply like this. Let's take this example. How it will apply? Like this. 4, 5, 6. Maximum is 6. What's the index? 2 is the index. 3, 4, 9. 2 is the index. 8, 1, 7. 0 is the index. Same way. 8, 11, 7. 11 is the maximum. 9, 1, 2. 9 is the maximum. 6, 12, 14. 12 is the maximum. That is how it will work. So 1, 0, 1. 220101. This is the output which we get when we apply the axis is equal to 2 means. If you don't mention any axis means, take the elements in a sequence and identify the maximum element. If you take these elements in the sequence, 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 9, 8, 1, 7, 8, 11, 7, 9, 1, 2, 6, 12, 4. This index value will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 is the index value. So the output which we get here is 16. Let's coming to the one-dimensional array. So in the one dimension, we are having only one axis. Axis is equal to 0. Don't get confused with the two-dimensional and one-dimensional. Axis is equal to 0 means in two-dimensional, it is working like this. Here, we don't have that dimension. So that's why it is working as a this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Out of this, what's the maximum value? This is the maximum value. So the index is 0, 1, 2, 3, third index. The output which it provides here is a third index value. That is how these points, axis, how axis works. That is very, very important to understand. Let's take some of the attributes and methods that works, how that are using all these axis variables. So coming here, import numpy as np, x is equal to np dot array of, this is the same example which we are considering here. Print x is equal to print x, y is equal to x dot t. T is an attribute. So capital T, what it will do here, it will transpose the matrix. We are taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Transpose means take the row, make it as column, take the second row, make it as column, take the third row, make it as column. Rows are converted to columns. That is what transpose means. After that, what's the output? 1, 6, 11. So 1, 6, 11 will come like this. That is how it is transposing. This is T is the variable used to transpose the data. And x dot data of starting address of the array element. So what's this data attribute will provide? Starting address of the array, how the memory is allocated, what's the need of starting address, all these things were clearly discussed in our previous class when we discussed memory allocation to the NumPy arrays. This is the starting address provided. It is provided in the hexadecimal, and x dot size means number of elements in the array and how many elements are there in our array. That is what it is provided. 15 elements are there. Size attribute will provide the number of elements. X dot item size means each element is taking how many number of bytes. That is what the item size attribute will provide. Each element integer, it is taking 4 bytes of space. X dot n dimension of how many dimensions we are having in our array, 2 dimensional array. That's why it is giving the n dim means number of dimensions. What's the maximum dimension we are having in the, so print x dot shape means the shape of our 3, 5, that is what the shape of our matrix is. These are the some of the attributes. There are many, we will discuss whenever they required. Up to now these attributes are enough to solve our placement and all those questions. So coming to the next one, we are discussing some of the attributes, the examples which we considered, the examples which we discussed in our previous slides about the access. These examples are considered here. NP dot array of x argmax of axis is equal to 0. Axis is equal to 0 means it works like this. 4, 3, 8. What's the maximum one? 8 is the maximum. What's the dimension? It's the 2, 0, 1. 5, 4, 1. Which one is the maximum? 5 is the maximum. That's why index is 0. 6, 9, 7. Which one is the maximum? 9 is the maximum. So output is 1. This is how it works. And next, coming to that, axis is equal to 1 means it works in this direction. 4, 5, 6. What is the maximum? 2 is the maximum. 3, 4, 9. The same example. That's why we are going little bit fast. 3, 4, 9. What's the maximum? 2 is the maximum. 8, 1, 7. Here we have written some mistake in our previous slide. So we have written it as 2, but here it is 0 index. 8, 1, 7. What's the index? 0 index. It's came here 0. 2, 2, 0. So np dot array of the same example, if you don't give any dimension, what's the output it will give? 5th index. And coming to the 3 dimensional, this is how we are taking the 3 dimensional array. This is the original array which we considered. Out of this we are going to identify the argmax of axis is equal to 0 means 8, 4. Which one is the maximum? 8 is the 4, 8. So it will come like this. We had shown like this. This is the 0th, this is the first one. Here it is displaying 0th one, first one. So 4, 8, which one is the maximum? 8 is the maximum, so index is 1. 5, 11, which one is the maximum? 11 is the maximum, index is equal to 1. This is how NumPy arrays axis will work. Wherever you got the attribute called axis, it works similarly. Not only in this method, in our entire NumPy arrays, wherever you got the option of axis, that axis is equal to 0, axis is equal to 1, axis is equal to 2, works similarly whichever the way we discussed here. Next, coming to the 3 dimensional array, axis is equal to 1 and the output is displayed here, the same output which we discussed in our previous slides. Next one is coming to 3 dimensional array and axis is equal to 2 means the same example which we discussed previously. Now coming to the axis, if we don't mention the axis, it will take all the elements and the index which we got here is 16, the same index in our previous example which considered. Now coming to the remaining some of the methods which we use here, argmax of axis is equal for single dimensional also, this is the example. The next example which we consider, so argmin of, it will identify the minimum element index values. Here we are showing only one example. This applies to all the axis is equal to 0, axis is equal to 1, axis is equal to 2, no axis, all those things. We are showing just the, you have to understand what's the meaning of this method. Remaining terms, whatever the condition you mention here, those are similar to any method. The same example we discussed previously. Coming to the next one is Next method is max method. Here argmax means it is identifying the index value. Here max means it will identify the value. It won't give the index out of this axis is equal to 0. What's the maximum value we have? That value will be returned. So 859 is the maximum value. Min means it will return the minimum values. Next, mean method. If you mention axis is equal to 0 means out of that it will identify the mean value. Mean value will be identified. X dot mean of. So next one is the most important one which we use mostly in data science is reshape method. We can change the shape of our arrays. If you take two dimensional array, you can convert into three dimensional, you can convert into single dimensional, like that we can reshape the way we like it. So how to reshape it? Let's take a single dimensional array 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, means total we are having 9 elements. We are reshaping it into 3 by 3, means two dimension. We are converting this single dimensional array into two dimension. But one more important point you have to understand here, whenever you are trying to reshape it, it has to match that. See, 9 elements are there, we can convert into 3 by 3, you cannot convert into 4 by 3. So that matching should be happened, otherwise it won't convert. So 3 by 3, what's the output here? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. It is taking the first 1 2 3, taking it as a 3 by 3 dimension, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is how it will convert. Let's try some of the examples. Take the single dimension, and here minus 1 is an option. This minus 1 option means we are not mentioning how many columns are needed. We don't know how many columns. We have mentioned only 5 rows should be there. So it will automatically adjust the number of columns. Whatever the required columns we get from this single dimension, it will take 5 rows and it will automatically adjust. See, total how many numbers are there? 10 numbers are there. If you take 5 rows means how many columns we will get? 2 columns. 5 to 10. If you have 15 numbers, it will automatically, that is what the meaning of minus 1 means. I am not specifying how many columns are needed. You take according to the data, but we are mentioning that 5 rows should be compulsory. So this option is available for only one time. You cannot give it for both the ones. If you are taking three dimensional, you can specify one dimension as minus 1. Remaining dimensions you have to specify. Only one option can be written as minus 1. We'll check that example also. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. According to the data, it will automatically adjust. So next one is we are taking two dimensional data and we are converting it into three dimension, reshape of 2, 3, -3, 2. See here, how many elements are there? 4, 5, 6, 1, 3, 4, 9, 8, 8, 1, 7, 7. Total 12 elements are there, two dimension into 3 into 2, 6. So 12, total 12 elements can match to three dimensional space, 2 into 3 into 2. So 12 elements will be there. So that's why we can change this two dimensional array into three dimension. So how it will take? 4, 5, 6, 3 into 2. Total how many rows we needed? 3 rows are needed, 2 columns are needed. So 4, 5, 6, 1, 3, 4, like that it will consider. How it will consider? Let's take this here. 4, 5, 6, 1, 3, 4, 3 into 2, 6. Like that, one more, 9, 8, 8, 1, 7, 7. This is how it will convert our given two dimensional array into three dimensions. Now coming to the next method is sort method. We can sort the elements that are present. We can mention the axis also. Out of this, which axis we have to get sort? Means it is an in place method. In place means it will automatically change the elements that are present in the array. It is in place means it will modify it and it will restore it in the same location. So means modify, elements will be modified. After sorting, it is the output is 4, 5, 6, 1. Output is 1, 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 9, 8, 3, 4, 8, 9, 8, 1, 7, 7, 1, 7, 7, 8. This is how it is taking. And the next example of in the sorting, it is mentioned as axis is equal to 0 means it works like this. By default, it is taking axis is equal to 1 means it is working on this direction. So axis is equal to 0 means 4, 3, 8. What's the output? 3, 4, 8, 5, 4, 1, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9, 7, 6, 7, 9, 1, 8, 7, 1, 7, 8. This is how it is working. Axis is equal to 0 means these are the methods which we use mostly in NumPy. In our data science playlist, we will discuss the methods that are required, that is mostly used in data science. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.